Hi, I'm Daniel Chan. I'm from UNSW Australia. In this short video, we'll be looking at the principle of inclusion and exclusion in set theory. Our question today looks at the following. We have 150 students. They're drinking three beer brands. The names of these beer brands are A, B, and C. And we're given that 58 of these 150 students drink brand A, 49 drink B, 57 drink C, 14 drink A and C, 13 drink A and B, 17 drink B and C, and 4 drink A, B, and C. And the question asks us to determine how many drink none of these brands. Now, there are two ways to do this problem, and the first method that I'll give you is the easier one of the two. So method one involves using Venn diagrams, and to start, we'll draw a big box. And this represents the 150 students that we have to begin with. We then let script A denote the set of all students who drink brand A. Script B equals the set of students who drink brand B. And script C be the set of students that drink brand C. Now, each of these regions corresponds to certain groups of students. So for example, if you're in all of these three circles, that means that you drink all three brands. In other words, you drink brands A, B, and C. So you're one of these four students here, if you belong to this here. So what we'll do is we'll put a four here to represent that. Now suppose you drink brands A and C. So you're one of these 14 students. That means you're in here and here, which means you're in one of these two regions here. Okay, so if you're one of these 14 students, you could be the four that also drinks brand B, or one of the 14 minus four, which is 10, which drinks A and C, but not B. Okay, similarly, we can look at those that drink A and B. So there are 13 such students. Of those 13, four also drink C. So if you have 13 minus four, that's 9 that drink A and B, but not C. And in this region here, we have those that drink B and C, but not A. Okay, now how many drink B and C? B and C, there are 17 such students. And if you subtract the 4 that also drink A, they leave 13 remaining. So we can put a 13 there. Okay, so now we want to populate these three remaining regions. If you look at the number of students who drink brand A, there are 58. So of those which do not drink neither B nor C, we have to remove this 10, this 4, and this 9. So we have the 58 that drink A, minus 10 is 48, minus 4 is 44, minus 9 is 35. And that's the number of students that drink A, but neither B, or rather C, nor B. Okay, to fill in this region here, how many drink brand B? 49. And to find the number here, we have to remove this 9, 4, and 13 students that also drink either A or C. So we have 49 minus 9 is 40, minus 4 is 36, minus 13 is 23. And finally, for this region here, we look at the 57 students that drink C. 57 minus 10 is 47, minus 4 is 43, minus 13 is 13. So we've got all the students that drink at least one of these three beers, and we're asked to find the students that drink none. How many are there? Well, there are 150 students total, so that the number of students who drink none is 150, and you subtract all of these numbers here. 35 minus 10 minus 4 minus 9 minus 30 minus 13 minus 23. And if you want to be safe, you can put that in the calculator and you can work out the answer as 26. So that's the first way of doing this question, using Venn diagrams, and it's the easiest way to do it. For the second way, I'll start over here. You might want to ask the question, can you answer this question with a formula? And the answer is yes. And what formula is that? The formula is called the principle of inclusion-exclusion. So the easiest way to write the formula is as follows. Suppose we look at the union of these three sets. That's A, union B, union C. And we want to know the number of elements inside there. So we use these vertical lines to denote the number of elements or the cardinality of this set. Well, it's given as follows. It's the number of elements in A plus the number of elements in B plus the number of elements in C minus the number of elements in A intersect C minus the number of elements in A intersect B minus the number of elements in B intersect C, and then finally you have to add in the number of elements in all three, in A intersect B intersect C. Okay, so just a quick reminder, what's the best way to remember this rather long formula? Well, in this formula, what types of things do you add? Firstly, the number of elements in each of the three sets, number of elements in A, B, and C. And what are terms that you subtract? Well, whenever you intersect two of these three sets, for example, A and C, or A and B, or B and C, you subtract the number of elements in those double intersections. And finally, you have to add the number of elements in the triple intersection. And there's only one because there are three sets here. And for three sets, this is the full formula. Okay, so now we just have to put in all of these numbers in. And in this case here, we find that these numbers are already just given to us. So indeed, the number of elements in this set script A is just number of students that drink brand A, so that's 58. And here you have the number of students who drink B, so that's 49. And the number of students who drink C is 57. And then you have to subtract these three in double intersections, so that's 14, 13, and 17. 14, 13, and 17. And finally, you have to add the number of elements in the triple intersection, 4. You can put this into the calculator if you want, or work it out, and you'll find that the answer is 124. Okay, so to finish this question, we have to work out how many students drink none of these brands, and we have to work out what set that corresponds to. So what is this union? The union is the set of all students who drink A or B or C. So what we want is the complement of this set, and more precisely, the number of students in that complement. So we're looking at A union B union C, the complement of that, and the number of students there. So how do we work out that complement? Well, there are 150 students total. So we take 150 and we subtract 124, and the remainder is 26, which is the same as the answer that we had when we used method 1 using Venn diagrams. Thank you.